Okay, so just before the break, what I would like to do is talk about what you're actually working on the standardization aspect for MISP. This is something I initially don't really like too much because I think everyone in the room knows this quote from Andrew Tannenbaum, which is basically saying that the nice thing about standards is that you have so many to choose from, so basically you have too much standard. And I tend to agree with this quote, and people might wonder, okay, you jump into the trap, so you create a new one. I would say yes at the beginning, but it's not really the case. Just for your information, that's basically some of the thread sharing standards that are available, and there are many others. You might know some of them. We are involved even in some of them. We are a contributor into the OASIS forum for basically the CTI part for the Sticks 2. Something versions, so the JSON-based version of Sticks. There are many others. For example, you have the OpenTPX, which is more targeting mitigation aspect into thread sharing. One that is well known in the IETF community is IODF, which is basically more for incident-related. But you see that some other standards, like Sticks, for example, basically have incident elements, which might overlap with IODF, which is quite interesting too. Facebook has a thread exchange format too, which is their own stuff because it's based on their API. You might know OpenIOC, which is covering the indicator aspect of sharings. Then you have a special group at ITU that are basically taking back existing standards and making new standards out of it, which is quite interesting too. So you see that you have many standards. And so why would you jump as MISP project into this whole discussion about standards? So here is the background of it. So when MISP was designed, and it's still the case, we basically don't design specification and then we do the software. It's probably the opposite. What we decided to do is we have a problem to solve, we do software, and we hope that the software that we do is trying to solve our problems. And if something goes wrong, we basically go back, start from scratch, reboot the software, and so on. That's why even that we have now going into the modular approach into MISP, is basically sometimes we want to try out something, see if it works. If it doesn't work, we basically scratch the software, do it again, and that's it. So for us, and this is one of the old statements, it's basically code is law. The application is basically the law behind. But we had a recurring problem in the past, I think it's more of the past year. We get many email requests, people that want to implement in their tools the MISP format. Why? It's because that the MISP platform works, they have their software that works too, and they just want to import MISP event, for example, into their platform, so they can want to export it. And every time what we have is basically email of people coming, or organization, vendors, coming back to us asking, oh, yeah, it's nice, I would like to do it, but this field, is it this, or the UID should be in this format? And after, I don't know, multiple emails, we're like, okay, we should document it. And a way to document it was basically, why don't we take the approach of the internet draft? Because it's formalized, it's easy to use, and we basically document it in one way, and in the same way we can publish internet draft at the end. So we basically to start in that side. So basically we started with two elements, and I will go into the details, but the core format and the taxonomy format are no internet draft. And our main goal was basically to remove ambiguities, and the most important part for us was to scale better. So I mean, if we receive each time vendor emails that want to implement something, we can say, okay, you have an internet draft there, look at it, and if you have any ambiguity, just pull request something, but basically everything should be there and you can do your stuff. So it's basically why we go a standard. We don't want to basically build a standard that everyone will use. We just want to build a standard that is basically in line with our software. So there is nothing attached to that. Already today, we got question on Twitter about people like, yeah, but what about Sticks? Will you be compatible? And so on. Yes, for sure. But it's completely independent from that. It's basically what we want to do is to have a correct documentation of our output format. And our output format is basically designed to be as simple as possible because it's basically bound to our implementations. And if you make a complex standard, you make complex software. And we try to avoid this part. So that's why we basically start into the standard process. So basically there are two specifications that are currently published. So it's Twint and Draft. One is a core JSON format of MISP. So what is basically the core format of MISP? It's quite interesting because when we wrote those drafts, we started to have multiple questions like, are we sure that we mean that for that? And do we still need that? And so it was a kind of good review of the format itself. So basically, the event format was described. So basically the meta information around it, the attributes, the shadow attribute, which is basically the, how you may create proposals. And an additional one, which is the manifest format, which is an easy format in JSON to bundle multiple MISP events. When you fetch an OSINT feed in MISP format, you basically fetch a manifest file. So that's basically the core format. It's around 45 pages, so it's very small. You have even sample files and so on, so it's straightforward. Then you have another format, which is the taxonomy format, is the one to describe the taxonomies, so the triple tax. So it's a JSON format to make it parsable. So the two standards that the current specifications. Those one are published as individual standards. So I don't know if you know how the IETF work, but you can basically publish any standard as you want. And then you can create, or you can basically incorporate your standard into work groups. So our current goal is basically to have a standard that is individual, published. And if at some point one interested work group at the IETF is interested into our standard, they can pick it and start to work on it if they want. But we basically want to continue to have a continuous stream of publishing our standard as internet draft. That's basically it. We have some other specifications that will be published. For example, one is the modules protocols. It's already existing. It's already implemented. But we still need to refactor some parts, especially for the asynchronous part and so on. So basically, those three specifications will be published later on. One is the Galaxy format, so all the Galaxy format sits on top of the event format, which is basically the core format before. Then the module protocol is all that MISP is communicating with the external modules. The goal behind is basically that people implement their own modules. They just read the document and they can even implement communication protocol that is compatible. And then we have a third one because we have some prototype code still not published, but would be one of the external projects in MISP. It's a way to vote and score for feeds. Every day you see so many people complaining on the internet about quality of feeds, quality of data, it's not good enough and they need to be improved and so on, it's great. But there's a fundamental problem is no one is really doing scoring. So you can complain as much as you want, but basically you can say, okay, what is the top feed provider and what is the crappy one? That's the thing. So the idea behind is to have as MISP as modules with feeds, we want that user of MISP would vote for the feed. So like that you can say, I like this feed, I dislike this feed. So like that you can even have a protocol of communication with a centralized server, which is basically having all the voting part. And then you can say, okay, I want to keep those feed because they are highly voted and I don't want to use those again. The idea behind is basically to use this voting as a scoring mechanism to, for example, do the expiration of fields or indicators within MISP. So it's basically to start from scratch something new. It's again an experiment. It might fail. You have been warned, but it might be interesting at the end to come with something that is working and functional. So to summarize quickly, it's basically if you go on MISP project, MISP-RFC, you will go on a simple Git repository with a draft in a Markdown format, text output. And then you can create issues if you see typo, if you see things that you need to be modified. If at some point you extend MISP in some other way and you want to have additional attributes and so on, you can basically provide additional information. So that's basically it for the standard. I don't know if there's any questions, comments. Is there any OSS member here? No? Okay. Okay. Thank you very much.